Before we start our discussion on dates, I just want to recap the concept of blue versus green.
So blue fields are discrete.
They create headers, they slice, and they dice. And they contain a finite number of values. Whereas green fields are continuous. They create an axis, and they're things that you can sum up and do maths on. They contain an infinite number of values. So how does that apply to dates? Let's take a look at this view. Why do you think there's a gap in between every line? Every pane, sorry. Exactly, because each date part of order date is being treated as different buckets. Now, let's convert this to continuous. To convert that to continuous, just click on the bottom pane here. So, because at the top, it's ordered the same as the pane. So at the top, you've got your blue, which is dimension. At the bottom, you've got your green, which is measure. So I'm just going to simply switch it across. So what's different about this as I expand the hierarchy? Exactly, sales is now on a continuous axis. And notice that as I expand the hierarchy, each date part wasn't separated into its own element. Let's look at another example. I want it as discrete month. Okay, so how is this different to, oops, I wanted to duplicate that. Let me convert this to continuous. So how is this view different to this view? They both got month of order date, don't they? What if I bring year of order date to color? Do you see what's happening now? So the discrete example is creating buckets of January's, February's, March, March's, whereas the continuous example is treating the months in chronological order. So let's get back to our diagram and see what dates do. See what discrete and continuous dates are doing. So discrete dates aggregate the measure to the date part selected. So it's slicing and dicing by, so in this example, it's slicing and dicing by month and piling all the years worth of January's and February's together. Whereas continuous date part of month has been transformed into a continuous axis in chronological order. Now there isn't a right or wrong way of displaying dates, it just depends on what you're aiming for in your analysis. Can anybody think of any business scenarios when you may want to use discrete dates over continuous?